Hi, Lauren here from the Mohonk Preserve. I'm one of the education coordinators, and I have another nature nugget for you. So this time we're going to be talking all about trees, trees as habitats. So this is a really great activity for really all ages to go out and explore, but mostly for the preschool onto younger elementary age students. So trees as habitats. First of all, what is a habitat? A habitat is a home. It's a safe place for a plant or an animal. And a habitat provides everything that plant or animal needs. So it's going to give them food, it's going to give them water, it's going to give them shelter, it's going to give them space, and it's going to give them oxygen. Almost all living things need oxygen. So trees as habitats is just that. Trees are going to, they need a home for themselves. They're in a habitat, but they can also provide habitat for many different kinds of plants and animals. So today outside in my yard, we are going to be looking at trees. As you can see, there are a lot of trees in my yard. So we're going to be looking at a few trees and looking for some habitats that, some things that, habitats that trees provide for our plants and animals. So let's take a look at a few places. Okay, so way up high in this awesome tree, there is a nest. It's that little clump of leaves that you can see right there in the crook of those branches. Now, you can have your child, your student, try and guess who made that nest, see if they can figure it out, what kind of materials are being used, and maybe have them watch the nest for a little bit and be like, oh, is there anything that's coming and visiting this nest? Now, I happen to know that this is a squirrel dray. So squirrels make nests that they use high up in the trees, and it provides shelter for them and protection for them. And they'll be pretty busy in the fall adding to these, building these. You'll see them collecting lots of leaves in the fall, and they'll use these throughout the winter time. So up there is a squirrel dray, a wonderful protective shelter space for our squirrels there. All right, so I found a downed tree, a dead tree. It's been down for quite a while, and there's lots and lots of holes that are in this downed tree. So there's some big holes, but then if you look close, there's little holes too. You can have your kids guess who made those holes. Now, the big holes here are made by a pileated woodpecker. The smaller ones are made by smaller kinds of woodpeckers, downies, hairies, red-bellieds. So there's lots of evidence that the woodpeckers have been here. Now, they're looking for not wood, but they're looking for insects. So that means that this tree had provided a great habitat for insects to live inside, and it provided food for the woodpeckers. Alright, same downed log, and there's a really awesome hole in this log. Any guesses about what is in there? I have no idea, but I can imagine on a cold, rainy, maybe even snowy night, that an animal, raccoon, well, that'd be kind of a small raccoon, but maybe squirrels, chipmunks, something, would want to hide out in that hole, get protection. Okay, on the ground, I have found some evidence of some food. So this is some husks from a nut from one of the trees on the ground. There's lots of acorns back here, lots of hickory, things like that, right back here in the woods behind my house. So trees are providing food, other food sources, not just insect food, but fruit food. So nuts and berries and goodness. So this was just, I just spent a few minutes out in the yard, in the woods around my house here, and I found all these different examples of trees as a habitat. So if you don't have extensive woods by your house, right in your own backyard, that's okay. I'm sure you have a tree somewhere in your yard or in your neighborhood, in a local park. Go for a walk and have your kids check out all the different ways that trees are habitats for plants. plants and animals. It's a really fun scavenger hunt, really fun way to explore your neighborhood and take a closer look at trees. So there's a lot of different things to see out there, and you'll probably see different things than what I saw out in my backyard. So keep your eyes open. Have the kids tell you what they think made a nest or is in a hole or made the holes, and try and figure, see if they can try and figure out what the animals were looking for, and what they might have been doing, and have your student also adopt a tree. Have them spend some quality time every day or so just sitting underneath their tree and observing their tree, and see if they sit quiet enough, if anything comes and visits the tree, and how the tree is helping them out and helping out your home and what the tree is providing for you. It is kind of providing habitat for you as well. So until next time, get outside, explore nature, and we'll see you again.